right? So when we are going to study sociocultural anthropology, you have to understand about some keywords like culture, civilization, society, social group, social institution, community, association, band, tribe, right? So these are the important concepts which we utilize for the understanding of sociocultural anthropology again and again. Means when we are going to study about marriage, family, kinship, economic organization, political organization, religion, tradition, we use that term. So before we are going to study about sociocultural anthropology, we try to understand about that keyword, right? So first, we try to understand culture. So what do you mean by culture? What you understand culture?
Way of life.
A way of?
Life.
Right? He is saying culture is the way of life. But you try to understand culture is the sum total of learned behavior of mankind. This is the broad concept regarding culture. It is not only way of life, it is sum total of learned behavior of mankind, right? Means man is a animal. Naturally, man is a biological animal. But when human baby take birth, that started learning their culture. So we study each and everything in culture, which is the product of our learning system. So culture is the sum total of learned behavior of mankind. Means in animal kingdom, no any animal can capable to make culture. Only human being capable to make culture. So as a biological animal, we are the product of nature. But after birth, we learn each and everything, how to make social relationship, how to reproduce child, how to care child, how to produce agriculture product, how to govern our society, how to worship our God and Goddess. This thing we always learn from our culture. So each and everything which we learn through the process of socialization, this is the culture. And it has two important aspects. First is material culture, and second is non-material culture. Are you interested in material culture and non-material culture?
Whatever we use, that is material culture.
So we learned how to produce that material culture. Are you understand when we are at as an animal being? So we are not human. Human evolved from ape. So ape is animal being. But when our ancestor started tool making, that is a material culture. That is a component of material culture. That is a part of material culture. So we learn that thing, how to make that material culture, how to produce that material culture, how to use that material culture. This is the part of culture. So each and everything which made by man related to material culture, that is the part of culture. Second important thing is that non-material culture means ideology, thought, belief, God and goddess, tradition, custom, social relationship. This is the part of non-material culture. So when we try to understand culture, you have to understand culture in this way. Right? Second important concept, civilization. So what is civilization?
Advanced.
So basically, civilization is the advanced stage of culture. Advanced stage of culture. Right? So according to anthropological perspective, and that perspective developed by famous classical evolutionist anthropology, L.H. Morgan, he said that civilization is the advanced stage of culture, means when there was development of urban society, right? Complex society. Complex economy. Or monetary economy. State formation and written script. When this type of cultural element develop in society, that society at the stage of civilization. Are you understand?
So earlier civilization was not there, in prehistory and all that.
There was not civilization. Even when we are going to study Vedic culture, so that is the culture. If you utilize term Vedic civilization, means you utilize wrong term for denoting Vedic culture. But we utilize term Indus civilization.
So written script was not there in Vedic, that's the one reason. Basically, all these elements has to be present.
This all or most of all present in civilization. Basically, Vedic culture was village culture, rural culture. There was no urbanization. There was no complex economy, complex society. There was no state formation. There was no written script. So in Indian term, when you utilize term.
Sir, what do you mean by complex society? In the society where the stratification is there.
Complex means the complex social relationship.
Like
today we live in complex society.
Social relationship stratification here is mostly.
Yeah, stratification also present there in complex society.
What about the other social relationship like from the
social relationship means in complex society, individuality develop in society.
There might be having some kind of individuality.
There is something related to individuality, but complex society is that society where the basic social institution, the role of basic social institution is not dominant like marriage, family, kinship, and a relationship regulated through government, through estate.
How can relationship government?
Relationship governed by government, governed by rule. Right? Because in complex society there is codified law, So relationship regulated according to the law of that society. That society is complex society. Right? So this is civilization. What is society? What do you mean by society? Society is the network of social relationship. Right? Means when an individual connect with another individual and all individual connect with each other through social relationship, that is called society.
How do you define a social relationship? Friendship, marriage, family?
Social relationship means continuous social interaction. If there is continuous social interaction between two or more than two individuals,
social interaction mein kya hai, baatcheet, social interaction aur kya,
take and give. You can take material, non material, you can take ideology, you can maintain your social relationship through conversation, through social obligation. Right? So society means group of people which has social relationship, and they maintain their social relationship continuously through social interaction. This is society. But when you try to understand that thing, you have also understand that thing into perspective. Some concept is structural. Structural
society,
and some is functional. Always remember that thing when you are going to study about social anthropology. Means here, when you are talking about society, that is a structural concept. That is not a functional concept. Generally, people said that society has done this work. Society has not done any work.
Mm-hmm. Is just a group.
Society is a structure. It has no any function.
No, what do you mean by structure? So how do you say that society
is a structure? Means,
structure means just a group of people.
A structure means group of people interacting with each other according to a structure of their society. Means when you are calling, yeah, saying about tribal society or band society, right? So their social structure is based on the concept of similarity. There is no social stratification in that society, right?
Similarity on what basis? Obviously, similarity will be on some basis, right, sir?
Similarity on the basis of social relationship, similarity on the basis of their economy, their political organization, their religion, each and every aspect, they all are equal. Because that society is based on the concept of equality. So, in their structure, you have not found that is at higher position, that is at middle position, and that is at lower position. But when we are saying Hindu society or caste society, caste-based society, means their social structure is based on the concept of social stratification. class society is also based on the concept of social stratification. So a structure of class society is quite different from the structure of band society or tribe society. So always remember, when we are going to study society, that means a structural concept, that is not a functional concept. Means society has not done any function in society. In general, you are using again and again that term, society has done this work, society has done
like
that work.
Like head hunting is done in Naga tribes.
Right.
That particular society is doing that kind of tribes, so that is not the structural function.
Society has not done any work. First thing you have to remember.
Then who does?
The member of society.
Society, those thing looks like society has done this. So society has done their work on through social institution, because social institution is functional concept.
So, sir, if you are saying society is nothing but
society is a group of individuals
who are
who bond together on the basis of social,
who are bonded with social relations.
Social relationship.
But obviously, for example, if you took the took like Naga tribes are indulged in head hunting. So Naga tribe is a part of the society.
Yeah.
So they are indulged, huh?
Yeah.
So we can say that society is obviously social institution. They have made certain social institutions.
Society fulfill their need through social institution. So in social anthropology, when we are going to study society or institution of society, always remember that some concept is a structure, means that is not doing function. First thing we
function
remember.
Of the culture, what kind of like some kind of culture function.
Second important, when you are studying about concept of social institution, here I am saying that it is a functional concept. It is a functional concept. So how we can say it is a functional concept, right? So for the understanding of social institution, here I am saying that social institution is a functional concept. It is not a structural concept, right? So you are studying marriage, right? So marriage is a social institution. It is a social institution. Marriage has not any structure.
Institution वही होता है ना कि जो कुछ functions के मतलब कुछ भी करे.
Institution refer to rule, regulation, right? So marriage is a institution. It has no structure. It has only function. So marriage does important role for society, because marriage give permission to make sexual relationship between husband and wife, and children born after that sexual relationship, that is legitimate children.
Marriage is an institution.
So marriage is an institution.
Marriage is rule or regulation.
Yeah, marriage is rule and regulation. Right?
इसका कोई structure नहीं है.
There is no structure. If you try to understand that is a structural concept, so you are in wrong condition.
So structural concept वही structure हुआ क्या सर वही समझ में
नहीं आया. It is a structure of that house. What do you understand?
Structure
means
physical structure.
Structure means
what? The foundation.
Means try to understand here. Suppose there is a family, right? So here family, joined family, right? So it has a structure.
Joined family में दादा दादी है मतलब.
Right.
Like that.
So it has a structure.
ये तो सर बहुत बजट हो गया.
Means you try to understand your own family.
Okay sir, joint family what we have different members of the family is
there. Or nuclear family. There is a structure in nuclear family also.
Like husband, wife is there and their children.
Children.
Are there. So this is what is the structure you are telling.
This is a structure.
Okay, so members are the structure, you can say that.
Members interacting due to social relationship with each other. So how that they are interacting with each other, that form the structure of that society.
Okay, sir. So there is some kind of difference between the structure. Function will show that what kind of structure they will follow.
Function means work.
So obviously, sir, for example, if husband and wife are staying in a relationship, they will perform different structure, but their relationship will be different.
They are performing some important function according to social institution. Okay. As for example, division of labor, right, done in family, right? So that is the function of family. That is the function of family. Here, when you are going to study social anthropology, so family is both a structure and functional concept. A structural and functional. Right? So when you are going to study about function of family, it means you have to study family as a social institution. Family as a social institution, when you are going to study about function of family. And when you are going to study about types of family, right? Basically, you are going to study about a structure of family.
A structure where your member interacting with each other. Social relationship.
Yeah.
And function is like,
there is a structure of this chair.
Like there is a structure of this, right? Class.
So these types of structure available in society also. When you are saying that this is village society, so what picture present in your mind when you are saying this is rural society, this is urban society, this is metro society, this is tribal society, this is band society? So that society is not a material thing, material object. So you can see their structure, you can imagine their structure in your mind.
So what will be the function of this family? Structure, I understood that there will be so many members.
There are many functions of family. We study that thing in the topic of family. For example, family does socialization of their children. There is economic function of family, there is political function of family, there is social family function of family, religious function of family. We learn how to worship our God, why we believe in our God. Where we learn that?
In the family.
We learn that from family. Even we learn our language from family. So this is the function of family. So here family working as a social institution, right? So always remember that when you are going to a study institution, means this is the functional aspect of society.
Rules, regulations, kya karega?
Right? This is abstract. Social institution is abstract. Society is abstract. Social group is abstract. This is abstract. Are you understand? And social group is very similar to society, but here, when two or more than two people interacting with each other continuously, that is called social group. So social group is also a structural concept.
ग्रुप में भी तो वो इंटरेक्ट ही करेंगे, कुछ फंक्शन तो करेंगे नहीं फंक्शन वो रूल्स और रेगुलेशन क्या कुछ सिखाना
है. सो इट इज आल्सो ए स्ट्रक्चरल कांसेप्ट, राइट? बिकॉज ए स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्रुप वैरी फ्रॉम ग्रुप टू ग्रुप. एंड कम्युनिटी, यू आर आल्सो यूजिंग दैट टर्म कम्युनिटी again and again, right? So what do you mean by community?
Community is a group of people they are aligned with a particular cause or something like that.
What do you understand community?
There's a Buddha community, but they have some particular ideology or something like that, they bind that.
For the understanding of community, you can understand that thing. That is also a group of people, right? Who lived in particular geography. And survive through the resources of that geography. They collectively used resources of particular geography. They associate with each other on the basis of their geography. So always remember that when we are saying about term community, means that term associated with geography. Yeah. This is also a group of people who reside in particular geographical area.
So you are saying that collectively use resources.
Yeah.
So collectively, there is also some stratification is there.
We are Indian. Suppose. We are Indian community. So we live in India. We survive in India through the resources of India.
Okay.
Another important thing for the understanding of community, people who live in particular geographical area, they feel unity, right? That is called community.
Yes. On the unity on the basis of geography.
On the basis of geography. On the basis of geography. Geography is very basic thing for community. As for example, you are using term village community, and a particular village community.
For example, Ramgarh is there.
Ramgarh is a village. So people who reside in Ramgarh, they feel unity on the basis of Ramgarh, their village, their geography. There is village boundary in our village area. So people who live in particular village, they have sentimental relationship with their village. We are belongs from Indian community. We have sentimental relationship with India. So this is community. Right? This is community. Another thing is that association. Right? It is also a group of people. But which form? For the fulfillment of particular purpose. As for example, when you are saying a student association, right? So in association, also people interacting with each other, but their purpose, their goal, is fixed, and that association formed for the fulfillment of particular goal. Youth dormitory found in tribal society is also an important example of association. Youth dormitory. We will study that concept in second paper. But here you try to understand particular term, because if you have not very good understanding about that particular term and you are going to study about socio-cultural anthropology, you feel some confusion.
Yeah, this is very much important.
Right?
So these are structural concept, community and association.
Community is a structural concept.
Association is functional.
Both. Association is both structural and functional.
Because group will be there and they will perform a particular function.
Because that form for the fulfillment of particular target. So we fill our target through association.
So why community is not a functional concept?
So community is
people because the base of geography is there.
People live in particular geography when they feel unity, that is a community. But community also fulfill their need through social institution.
which require a social institution.
Community is basically society, but that society unite with each other on the basis of their particular geography.
तो
फंक्शन
तो कुछ करने रहा है, they are not
involved any kind of function. No function. मतलब इसका कोई purpose, ऐसा कुछ नहीं. Community का purpose survive करना है. तो community जो है, ये जो evolve हो रहा, that is the product of gradual process. We are not making community in one day. People living in a particular geographical area, and they slowly fill unity with each other, and then that community formed, right? So here we not formed community on a day, but we can form association and one day. If we are sitting here and we agree to form an association, right? So we make that association, and then we work for the fulfillment of the target of that association.
So sir, community also has certain functions. Sir, they are
staying. No function. Community has done their function through social institution, because each society has their social institution. As for example, I already said that society is a structural concept, but there is we feel there is some function in society, right? But exactly that function is happen in society, that basically done by their social institution.
Okay, matlab they are basically, you can say that group coming together to perform a particular function, that is association. But in community also, group is coming together, so social relation, they are not performing any function.
No, just
there. If they want to perform certain functions, then they have separate social institution.
Social institution. That social institution responsible for the performance of particular work, okay, particular
function. Within the community, if they want to combine a certain relation or be any, so friendship is an institution, marriage is an institution, like that.
Marriage is institution. Friendship is not institution.
That is just a social relation.
That is social relationship.
Okay. Marriage.
Right. And here, when you try to understand band society, that is a egalitarian society. Nomadic people, right? Tribe is also egalitarian society, but tribe live in particular geographical region. So on the basis of that, you can understand that important concept. Band is a group of people or a small society, a small nomadic society, which is egalitarian society. Tribe is also egalitarian society, but tribe lived in particular geographical region.
Or band kahin
rehta,
band kahin nomadic tribe.
Nomadic.
Aur ye kya static
hai? Static. So on the basis of that concept, you can understand socio-cultural anthropology, and you try to utilize that concept for the understanding of various social institutions, economic organization, political organization, religion, tradition. Because when you are going to study social anthropology and you don't understand that concept in the right way, so if you learn your books, material, and try to write something, and then there may be some wrong knowledge for you. So in that condition, you have to understand that concept, and this concept is useful for the understanding of socio-cultural anthropology.